Morning on KTRS.
Yo, listen up, here's the story about a little guy that lives in a blue world and all day and all night.
740, your Big 550 KTRS. Mark Remillard of ABC News is with us. Jack Dorsey from St. Louis, and I still can't get verified on my Twitter account, and Mark Remillard's going to help us do that. Mark, good morning. Thanks for checking in.
Good morning. That's right. They're opening up an application process now so that us mere mortals on Twitter can get our own little blue check mark if we so choose. And so you can go through this process, fill it out, and then it's still not guaranteed that you'll get the check mark, but at least they're opening up the process for people to now essentially apply for one.
Why are they doing this now? What's the impetus?
Well, you have the explanation from Twitter, and then I think you also kind of have the common sense explanation. So you have the explanation from Twitter, which essentially says we want to make it easier for people to find good accounts, that people look for that blue check mark on these very public accounts, journalists, musicians, television stars, these kinds of things. And then, they want to be able to allow that to come to more people. But then you also have the other side of this, which is Twitter's dealt a lot with harassment issues and these anonymous accounts who can really go and say things and fake accounts of other celebrities and these kinds of things. And so this could really cut down on that. While that's not what they say the purpose is, it is something that could help.
This comes on the heel of the whole Leslie Jones controversy where she's now left Twitter, but they've tried to ban some of the people who were trolling her.
That's right. Leslie Jones said that she came under fire essentially from just wide attacks from accounts giving her racist comments, misogynistic comments for being in that all-female reboot of Ghostbusters. And one of them, I'm not always great at pronouncing his name, but Milo Yiannopoulos, I believe is how you pronounce it. He's a Breitbart writer, and he was banned permanently from Twitter because they considered what he was doing for a long time to be offensive and harassment, and then especially because of some of the things that he had tweeted about Jones. And so they've actually permanently banned him from Twitter.
I guess Jack Dorsey reached out to Leslie Jones as well, right?
I did not see that, but they essentially, I'm sure that they, I wouldn't be surprised if they did. I did not see whether or not Jack Dorsey did that, but
yeah.
Considering the amount of harassment that she had received and that the swift response that Twitter gave to this by going through and banning a lot of these accounts, including one very public account. Milo's account was a very public account. He had more than 300,000 followers. Is a pretty swift response.
Is this the first time Twitter has actually publicly banned somebody for being so over the top?
It's not. They've actually done this in the past. They've handed down these kind of permanent bans on people before. One being, for example, Got News founder Chuck Johnson was permanently banned. And what this means is that they'll go through and they say that they'll continue to look for any accounts if they try to re-sign up. Now, for example, when you do this verification process, you have to have a verified phone number, email, these kinds of things. So obviously someone like Got News founder Chuck Johnson, who's been permanently banned, could go on there and try and get a check mark, but
right.
You know, that's what's to say you can stop you sign up under another email address that has nothing. You know, how would they know that that's them? But again, Twitter says that we'll look for that in the future, and if we feel that this is that person again, we'll ban them.
Being the egomaniac that I am, I've already gone on and applied for my blue check mark. It's very simple process, right? You just go to Twitter and sort of follow the link.
Right. Well, you go through and you got to fill out a form. You need to have a verified phone number, bio, your picture, a birthday, website, and email, and then you actually have to go through and tell them why you should be verified. And so this is where Twitter says that this is still meant for people of public interest. It just seems like the bar has been lowered, that you don't need thousands upon thousands of followers anymore to be considered of public interest. So someone who has very little activity or very few tweets, probably not going to get the check mark still, but at least you can apply. And so yeah, you go through and you tell them why you want to be verified, fill out your phone number, these kinds of things, and then they'll take a look at it and possibly give you that check mark.
Mark Remillard, thanks for checking in.
Thank you.
743 KTRS.